Hi, I'm Charlotte Strom. I am a painter and have been for a number of decades now. We are at Lyndon Street Artworks, where my husband Eric Strom and I share a studio space. We've been in this studio for almost 5 years now, and this is our home away from home. This is where we like to create our big paintings, small paintings, our paintings, all the same. And you can see a number of styles, number of types of medium, subject matter. It's all over the place.
And as she just said, my name is Eric Strom. I'm also a painter. We have a company called Strom Art LLC, and we do fine art, digital graphics, and illustration. And it's anything from children's books to corporate logo identity, t-shirt designs, etc. But most of our stuff is the big paintings that you see around us. And those are really done for us. And other things are client-based, but most of our stuff is what interests us and what we feel like painting. And about 5 years ago, Eric Bierbauer, who is a sculptor, and then Ernie and Lois Rich, who are also sculptors, they kind of got together, and the three of them kind of got Lyndon Street on the map.
Part of these last few years of being more in the moment with the art, I would set up a still life or set outside and actually put my easel out and look at the landscape that I was trying to recreate, and really have more of a recreation process. And now I feel like I'm having more of a creation process.
But I'm also very interested in geometry and patterns and interlocking patterns in design, sometimes very obviously, and sometimes more where it's hidden. It's not very, it's just more about the composition creates a pattern, and sometimes it's very, very obvious where I'm putting circles and lines and squares, and the lines create the figure. Both of us have been drawing since we can remember. It wasn't until about middle school that I realized that what I was doing was different. I thought everybody spent all their waking hours drawing, and I realized that it wasn't the case. When we were younger, you saw lots of kids with crayons and pencils, but I just figured that was normal. But I spent every waking hour drawing as much as possible all the time.
I remember making little storefronts out of refrigerator cardboard boxes and making little galleries with cutout windows, and I'd sell my drawings to my family in my living room for about 10 cents a drawing. And that was, I was just always yearning to do something just like this. So.
I like to go for the gut. A lot of times I have a tendency to let my brain get in the way too much, and even the way people think, your brain will tell you one thing, your heart will tell you another thing, but your gut usually steers you in the right direction. And we just want the right person to walk in front of the right piece. We know it's not for everyone, but we really want them to know that it's sincere. A real reaction from a viewer, whatever that is, something that sits with them a while, even if it's just an image they can't get out of their head, or makes them think of a memory, or anything that gets their brain out of neutral or autopilot. Come in, look around, get everything moving around, leave, and maybe that person will do something that they weren't going to do with their lives or that day, instead of going home and just watching TV or just wasting time. Maybe we helped get the wheels turning of imagination or brain, just something to get people out of the doldrum of everyday existence in today's society. It is pretty much our living. Down the line, like most artists, we did a million other things, and so we can become artists, and that was always, we did the art between the cracks of having 10 other jobs. And if you are an artist and you want to do that, or you want to be an artist, you need to be prepared to do a million other things in time and you will get to be an artist. And now this is pretty much our whole thing. And this place is here to show you, if you want to be a professional, real, hardworking artist, this is the place to be. And this is the place, it's an opportunity to be that.